Welcome back, students. Today we will study the chapter polymers. When we hear the term polymers, day to day life we are all using the polymeric utensils. So I brought some material. So we are using the container. Every house we are having container is a polymer. And is this a nylon? Is a polymer? The nylon is a polymer. I'm thinking that yes, nylon is also a polymer. And we are using a rubber band. Is this rubber band is a polymer? Yes, this is also a polymer. So polymer, we can say broadly, we can say plastics and the nylon and the rubber. These three will come under the category polymers. These three will come under the category polymers. Polymers. See, these polymers are very useful for our life in two purposes. The first one is polymer is cheaper. Why we are using the polymer? It is cheaper. And it is high tensile strength. High tensile strength. Previously we used iron furnitures, wooden furnitures. Now we are using the polymeric furnitures. Same tensile strength and also lightweight. Light in weight. So these are the three merits of polymers. So, first one is very cheaper compared to the rate of the cost of the wooden furnitures and the iron furnitures. Polymer is very cheaper and high tensile strength, withstanding capacity is more and the light weight. So, these three merits. So, everyone is preferring polymers. So, nowadays all the utensils we are converting into polymers. Isn't it? So, what are polymers? Now, the question is, what are polymers? How will you define a polymer? So, a polymer is a macromolecule. A macromolecule. So, made up of many monomers, contains many monomers. For example, polythene, we know that polythene. See, what is the name of this compound? What is the name of this compound? It is, yes, it is ethene. So, n number of ethene undergoes polymerization to form polythene. This is the formula for polythene. So, see, many N stands for polymeric unit. N stands for polymeric unit. So, this polymeric unit may be more than 10,000. 10,000 molecules of ethene combined. So, here you know that this is a double bond. The double bond. This is known as a single bond, sigma bond and the pi bond. These pi electrons are localized. They move and they will form a chain. Chain like this. So I cannot be able to write many ethene molecule. Many ethene molecule and I cannot be able to write 10,000 ethene molecule. So what I am doing is, I am writing one ethene molecule. I am putting n times. So what is a polymer? So, polymer is a macromolecule containing a large chain of monomer. This ethene is called as monomer. And this polythene is called as a polymer. So, here I will show, here you can able to see a chain. So, this chain, we can call it as this is a monomer. One single unit is a monomer. See how this is made up of the chain. See these many monomers are combined to form a polymer. Like this, a polymer will be there. So many ethene molecules combine in a linear way, the linear way, like a straight line, and it will form a polymer. So this polymer will have the molecular mass 10 to the power of 3 to 10 to the power of 7 mu. So high molecular mass, polymer has having high molecular mass. So do you understand the definition of a polymer? The polymer is made up of water. Polymer is made up of many monomers. Monomers. How many monomers will be there? More than 10,000 unit. Simplest example is polythene. Okay. So this is the definition of a polymer. Okay. So now let us move to the classification of polymer.